Following a recent video that explored the decision by Octopus Energy to allow more solar PV installations to access their Smart Export Guarantee, or SEG tariffs, we've had many questions, ranging from what is the SEG and how much do I get paid, to how do I set my solar installation to export power. Well, that's what we'll explore in this video, including a demo of the Smart Energy Export feature built into this SunSync inverter and the Connect app, plus how you can leverage battery storage to make more money and reduce your energy bills. While this video focuses on the U.K., Octopus Energy operates across Europe, the USA, New Zealand, and even into Japan. So if you're tuning in from these regions, we'd love to hear about any of the innovative approaches to the electricity market that you've come across, whether from Octopus or any other energy supplier. It would be fascinating to compare them with the techniques discussed in this video. Also, be sure to stick around until the end of the video because I'll highlight some common mistakes that people often make when choosing a battery storage system, preventing them from maximizing their investment. But first, let's talk about the Smart Export Guarantee and what it means for solar owners. Basically, it's a U.K. government-regulated scheme that allows energy suppliers to pay for unused electricity generated by an eligible solar panel system that's exported into the grid. This enables homeowners to benefit financially from their investment, but more importantly, plays a part in helping the U.K. meet its net zero commitments. However, there is a twist. If you're not on a SEG tariff, the excess energy from your solar panels gets exported back to the grid anyway without any payment. The only way to stop this would be to switch off your solar installation, which is a little bit daft because you wouldn't get the energy either, or store your energy in a battery like this one, or perhaps convert excess energy to hot water via an electric immersion heater, or charge an electric vehicle. You need a smart meter and two energy accounts to get paid for energy export, one for import and one for export. You must apply for another MPAN number from your energy supplier to obtain an export tariff. Interestingly, you can have different energy suppliers for import and export, which might not be wise, and here's why. Taking Octopus Energy as an example, the export-only SEG rate is currently 4.1 pence per kilowatt hour for each unit you export. So if you export 1,000 kilowatt hours per year, you'll get paid £41. Not exactly a life-changing amount, but it's better than nothing. Unless you go hungry and read by candlelight, you'll need to import energy during the dark days of winter, which typically you'll be paying 30 pence per kilowatt hour. So you get paid £41 to export, then you have to buy this energy back at £300. This is why having a battery storage coupled with your solar PV installation is so advantageous. Exporting power should really be the last option. Now, you may have heard that Octopus Energy have a better deal with a headline rate of 15 pence per kilowatt hour for export. To qualify for that rate, you also need to be buying your energy from Octopus. A typical fixed rate is currently around £0.27 for the energy that you buy from them. So in this case, our 1,000 kilowatt hours, you'd earn £150 for the export power, but you'd still be spending £270 to buy it back in winter. It's better, but not great. Is there a better deal? Well, of course there is, but you need to enter the world of smart energy tariffs and start playing the energy markets and trading your electricity.
Welcome to the SunSync Energy Desk. Let's take a look at today's electrifying trades. If it's a fixed return you are looking for, dive straight into the Octopus Flux tariff. You can buy energy during non-peak periods for 29 pence and sell for 18 pence. During peak periods, 4 p.m. until 7 p.m., energy buying is expensive at 41 pence, so it's a time to sell at 30 pence. The special flux rate kicks in between 2 a.m. and 5 a.m., which is the time to buy and get those batteries charging at 17.5 pence. Don't sell during this time as you'll only get 6.5 pence. If you buy low and sell high, you can make a profit of £125 on a 1,000 kilowatt hour deal. Looking for something a little more adventurous? It's time to plug into the Octopus Agile tariff. For the more sophisticated energy trader, you'll be playing the half hourly energy market and planning your trades a day ahead. With no sun, little wind and lots of rain, tomorrow's market is not looking great. The time to buy is between 4:30 a.m. and 5 a.m. with an import low of 15.75 pence, with another market low between 2:30 p.m. and 3:30 p.m. On the sell side, you need to be shifting your energy out between 5:30 p.m. and 7 p.m. to get a rate of 34.9965 pence per kilowatt hour. Following market rates and buying low and selling high, you could earn £192.50 on a 1,000 kilowatt deal. Agile rates change daily, so check back on the market tomorrow. I've heard strong winds are on the way, which means better prices for you. Terms and conditions apply, and figures do not include battery and cable losses. See datasheet for details. Charge and discharge limits apply. G98, G99, and G100 conditions may prevent your ability to export. Keith Goff's coming on eFix TV. Time to buy. Gary's bought a new hot tub. Sell.
Buy. Dope.
Got some renewables coming in for you. Time to buy. Steve sold his Jag. Time to sell.
Buy. Sell. Buy. Sell.
So you can profit from trading the energy market. Of course, the biggest returns are from selling the solar energy you generated for free. However, in all instances, you really do need to ensure you've maximized your self-consumption. It is no good selling your free and lower cost energy only to buy it back later in the day at peak time prices. And that's the great thing about having a battery coupled to solar installations. It allows the flexibility to shift your energy consumption to avoid peak time tariffs. Charge your batteries during the day from solar or from lower cost energy, and then use that energy in the evening and when you're back at home to avoid those peak time prices. It's only once you've maximized your self-consumption you should ever consider selling energy back to the grid. Now, before you decide to invest in a solar panel installation, it's absolutely crucial to gain a clear understanding of your energy usage patterns at home. This includes identifying the amount of energy you consume and the specific times of day when you use it. Now, ensure you've subscribed to this channel because we've got a great video coming soon with some really useful tools to help in that process. Now, having to remember when to charge, when to use, and when to sell energy takes some commitment. So luckily, SunSync have integrated the Octopus tariffs into the SunSync Connect app, which makes the process of managing energy simpler. Through the app, you can also gain day-to-day insights of your PV generation, energy consumption, and this combined makes it easier to decide on whether you should be selling energy back to the grid. So let's take a closer look at how we set up the Octopus tariffs on the SunSync Connect app. Starting from the app home screen, I simply tap the three dots next to the installation I'm connected to and click Edit. Scroll down to Valuation Method and touch the arrow next to Constant Price. So let's now change this to Live Price. You can see now that the Octopus tariffs are listed against the provider. So let's start with the Octopus Flux. You can see the flux and peak times are already programmed in. So between 2 a.m. and 5 a.m, the battery will charge until it reaches 100% capacity. During the peak period, time two, the battery will discharge until it reaches 40% state of charge. Depending on your own energy use, you may choose just to import during the flux hours and not discharge the battery to reserve the power for your own use and avoid peak time prices. Now let's explore how the inverter deals with the Octopus Agile tariff. The first difference here is you'll notice you have to select a geographic region. This is because power prices vary slightly depending upon local power grid conditions. So selecting our home patch of Yorkshire, then tapping the Octopus Agile rates brings in the current day pricing. So based upon these rates, you select a stop price for charging. In other words, my battery will start charging at any price below the selected rate, which, looking at current prices, selecting a price below 16.5 pence will ensure my battery has enough time to fully charge. I can also set the selling price as well. For instance, if I'm on holiday with low consumption energy, I would prefer to sell my energy from the battery when the price exceeds 34.7 pence per unit. Within the hour and a half window, I can sell all of the energy at the highest price. In terms of profit, I can probably generate enough funds for a few refreshing drinks by the pool. Now, you would need to keep a watch on the numbers to actually ensure the battery is charging and discharging. If you set numbers too tight to the market rates, you might find that you miss out and nothing happens. In terms of actual payment, the import and export are measured by the smart meter and paid via your electricity bill. You don't need to actually connect the SunSync inverter or the app to your energy account. Now let's delve into some essential advice regarding battery storage and inverters. It's important to be aware of the limitations when it comes to charging and discharging batteries, as the power handling capacity of the inverter combined with the battery determines this. We've encountered numerous instances where individuals have installed 20 kilowatt hours of battery storage paired with an inverter that can only discharge the batteries at a rate of 2.5 kilowatts. Consequently, this would result in an 8-hour discharge time for the battery setup, causing you to miss out on the optimal times for charging and discharging, and of course, the best prices that are associated with that. Furthermore, 2.5 kilowatts does not provide enough power for high usage periods within the property. So if you have a peak demand of 5 kilowatts, you need an inverter and battery setup capable of supplying 5 kilowatts. The alternative is to try and find a way of reducing your peak demand at home. I suggested this, switching the dishwasher on at 2 a.m. in the morning, but the response about who was going to be doing that wasn't pleasant. Now, of course, when it comes to shifting power, this SunSync inverter has another clever feature, which we'll explore in this video here.